Let's have a look on the top stories. News number 1. UAE to take action against nations refusing repatriation of migrant workers. The UAE plans to impose strict restrictions on countries reluctant to take back their nationals working in the Gulf country in the wake of the coronavirus outbreak and restructure its cooperation and labor relations with them, a state-run media report said on Sunday. The options being considered by the Ministry of Human Resources and Emiratization include imposing strict future restrictions on the recruitment of workers from these countries and activating the quota system in recruitment operations, state-run WAM news agency reported, citing an official. It said the options also include suspending memoranda of understanding signed between the ministry and concerned authorities in these countries. Citing the unidentified official, it said these options are being considered after many countries did not respond to requests by their nationals to return home following the outbreak. The official said all countries of for EIGN workers in the UAE should be responsible for their nationals wishing to return to their countries as part of an initiative launched recently by the ministry. Earlier this month, the ministry launched an initiative to enable residents who work in the UAE and wish to return to their countries to do so during the period of precautionary measures undertaken to contain the spread of the virus. Moving on the second news. Gina Dal Coleto is a 97-year-old great-grandmother and she's Brazil's oldest coronavirus survivor. When 97-year-old Gina Dal Coleto of Brazil was taken to hospital on April 1 with coronavirus symptoms, even the most optimistic person would not have expected her to survive. But on April 12, Dal Coleto was discharged from São Paulo's Vila Nova Star Hospital as doctors and nurses applauded her recovery. She became the oldest to survive COVID-19 in Brazil. This good news gives Brazil hope in these tough times as the country struggles to cope with the pandemic. She is only survivor of an Italian family which had 11 siblings. Dal Coleto lived alone in Santos, Rio do São Luís. Even with almost a century of life, Gina has a very active routine and enjoys walking, shopping and cooking, said the hospital's statement, according to Reuters. She has 6 grandchildren and 5 great-grandchildren, it added. She had been put on oxygen and was in intensive care, the statement went on to say. But now she is out and that is truly a miracle. Brazil's health ministry said 1,223 people were dead due to the outbreak and there are now 22,169 confirmed cases. Worldwide over 110,000 have died while more than 1,800,000 are affected. Moving on the third news. Thailand hospital designs tiny face shields for newborn babies so they're safe from coronavirus. With the coronavirus disease sweeping across countries and some hospitals being overrun with patients, the fear that mothers giving birth around this time are experiencing is palpable. While hospitals cope with the crisis, many pregnant women are worried about how the disease could affect their babies and wondering if maternity wards may experience a shortage of beds, staff or supplies. So much so, in some cases, pregnant women are considering avoiding hospitals entirely and instead opting to give birth at home or in a birthing center. Countries across the world take the best possible steps to face the surge of coronavirus patients. Many health facilities have had no option but to crack down on delivery rules for women going into labor. Many hospitals have now barred family and doulas from the delivery room. Apart from that, others are taking the best possible precautions to protect newborn infants from the deadly virus. One hospital in Thailand is taking extra special care of newborn babies amid the coronavirus pandemic by giving them adorable little face shields. Paulo Hospital in Samut Prakan province of Thailand recently posted adorable pictures of babies in the delivery ward of the hospital all dressed up in personal protection equipment, PPE. We have extra protection measures for little ones and friends, with a face shield for newborns. So cute, the hospital wrote on their Facebook post. Congratulations to all mothers and dads. Many have thanked the hospital for going the extra step to protect newborns from the highly contagious disease, so cute, wrote one Facebook user, while another said, nurse is doing a great job. While others wondered if the shields were uncomfortable for the little ones. Some offered a perspective saying that babies are too occupied sleeping to realize anything about the huge cover on their faces. Thailand has imposed a lockdown till April 15 to contain the spread of COVID-19. The country has recorded over 2,300 confirmed cases of coronavirus. According to a Guardian report, so far scientists have found no evidence that mothers who test positive for COVID-19 can transmit it to their fetuses in utero. Once the baby is born, the CDC recommends a temporary mother-infant separation for mothers who have COVID-19, and offers guidance on breastfeeding precautions. A New Scientist report states that doctors in China have been cautious, and people who are diagnosed with the virus shortly before giving birth have been separated from their newborn babies for 2 weeks. In this scenario, the babies were formula-fed, and appeared to be healthy. Moving on the fourth news. I need more beer. 93-year-old's Facebook appeal goes viral. Staying at home to protect herself against the coronavirus, one 93-year-old had a big problem: she was running out of booze. Olive Veronese decided the best way to keep her supplies up during the coronavirus lockdown was to get creative, and now, she's gone viral on Facebook. The pensioner, from Pennsylvania, was pictured holding a whiteboard that said, "I need more beer." In her other hand, a can of Coors Light. The photograph, taken through the window of her home, was uploaded to the Facebook page of a local TV station. Since then, it has been seen by more than 1 million people. Much more importantly, several people have offered to get the beers in for Olive. Moving on the fifth news. Spain to lift some of its COVID-19 lockdown rules. Some workers in Spain are preparing to return to their jobs as lockdown restrictions are relaxed. It comes after the country reported its lowest daily growth in confirmed coronavirus infections in 3 weeks. Health officials said there were 4,167 confirmed new cases and 619 deaths since Saturday. Spain's total number of COVID-19 deaths is 16,972, and its number of confirmed cases, more than 166,000, puts it behind only the US. More than 60,000 people have recovered from the disease. Workers in industry and construction will be able to return to work on Monday after a 2-week shutdown closed all sectors apart from healthcare and food. Shops will remain closed, apart from supermarkets, fruit stands, bakeries, butchers, news stands, and pharmacies. Those who can work from home will be asked to continue this. These rules are expected to remain into May. The move will be watched closely by other countries, amid fears that lifting restrictions too soon could allow a second wave of the virus. Those who do return to work should maintain social distancing, said Maria Jose Sierra, deputy head of health emergencies. She added that, if there is a person who shows the slightest symptom, they should contact the health system and remain in self-isolation. Meanwhile, China reported 108 new cases of coronavirus on Monday, bringing its total to 82,160. The first cases of the virus were seen in China and, around 5 months after that, the worst-affected region of Wuhan lifted its final travel restrictions last week. However, this has brought the problem of cases being brought in from abroad. Of the 108 cases confirmed on Monday, 98 were imported. And 7 of the new domestic cases were recorded in a province bordering Russia. China still has social distancing rules, temperature checks, and other measures while businesses reopen and people start to resume normal life. Moving on the sixth news. How to identify fresh fish from stale ones in lockdown days. Food safety authorities in Kerala, India have been busy seizing and destroying stale fish ever since the lockdown was announced. Most of these fish are laced with poisonous preservatives such as formalin and ammonia. However, you can follow these tips to identify fresh fish and protect the health of everyone at home. Ammonia is added to the ice in which fish is stored in order to delay the melting process. Formalin, the liquid form of formaldehyde, is normally used in mortuaries to preserve bodies. It has a high poisonous content and can cause cancer and ulcers. Formalin is also harmful to the digestive process and leads to diseases of the liver, kidneys, lungs, heart, and central nervous system. Another disease attributed to formalin is peritonitis. Signs of fish laced with formalin. Fish in which formalin is present can be identified by discoloration of the eyes, absence of natural odor of fish, and change in color of scales. Moreover, when formalin is applied to stale fish, it becomes stiff. When one small glass of formalin is dissolved in a bucket of water, the solution is sufficient to preserve 250 kilograms of fish for 4 days. Many unscrupulous merchants choose this method as storing fish in ice is not only expensive but also consumes more space. However, once formalin is applied to the fish, it cannot be removed entirely. In fact, it remains in the fish even after thorough washing and cooking fish at least thrice. Applying Bengal gram flour to the fish before washing is another way to remove toxic substances. Before making a purchase, check for the smell of ammonia or formalin and avoid such fish. Tips to identify fresh fish. Good fish can be located by sight, smell and touch. Fresh fish would come with bright, clear and round eyes. Stale fish have dull, shallow eyes with light blue color. Check the gills. Those of fresh fish would have the blood red color. If blood of normal color flows out from the area of the spine while removing the internal organs, the fish would be fresh. In case a bad odor is felt, you can assume that the fish is stale. Fish that begins to turn stale would have a heavy smell similar to that of ammonia. That's all for today. Stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for latest updates.